Hey guys, it's Renee. Welcome to this Hello Kitty Clear phone case. Now, I made this last year, this white Hello Kitty, and I love it, but I wanted to make the clear version of it. So I'm going to start with this clear case that I got online, actually, and I'm just going to try to link below where I got it from. And then I'm just going to be taking this acetate sheet and I'm just going to be putting my phone case on top of it, and I'm just going to mark the shape of it, and then I'm just going to cut it. Once I have cut this, because I want to actually use this, I'm going to be placing this between the phone case and my phone, and I'm just going to mark the space of the camera so I can use it and there's no plastic in between. I'm just going to be cutting that. It's pretty easy. And then I'm just going to be putting this on so you can see the glass is clear and there's no acetate sheet showing through. Now I'm just going to be putting my acetate sheet on top of my case because I want to see exactly where the face is going to go. And then here comes the fun. Now Hello Kitty is a really tricky kitty, but I'm here to show you the simplest way to do it. First, I'm going to add 3 dots for the nose and the 2 eyes. Then I'm going to be adding 1 eye. And then you can actually make mistakes like now in this acetate sheet. As you can see, the eye in there is not even. And so I'm just going to remove it with my Q-tip or just cotton and some acetone. Pretty simple, it comes right off. And this is the cool thing about working with acetate sheets. You can pretty much remove the design if you don't like it. I actually removed the one left eye a couple of times until I got it right. And then the nose like that. It's pretty simple, the nose. Just make sure it's centered. Then the other eye, and just take your time. You know, this is like the tricky part because she's pretty even. The rest is pretty simple, I'd say. Just the whiskers, 3 lines like that. One in the middle, one on top with a bit of an angle, and then one in the bottom with an angle as well. And then the bow, it's pretty simple. I'm just going to be adding one oval shape as I did with the eyes and nose and center, and then 2 shapes like that. Hopefully it makes sense because it was kind of like tricky to show you from the angle that I was. To paint this, I'm just going to be using yellow and red. My brush is going to be a toothpick. I was too lazy to work with a brush. I feel like most people don't really have, you know, detailed brushes. I feel like most people have toothpicks. And then I'm just going to be covering the bow. It's pretty simple. You just have to stay in the lines. I'm working with acrylic paints. And then I'm just going to be covering that one more time. And once I'm done and everything is dry, I'm just going to be going on top with my Sharpie. And I'm just going to define the bow because it got kind of lost with all the paint. And then at the end, I'm just going to add those details to make the bow pretty. And I'm going to be adding this in both sides. And yeah, then I'm going to be putting this on the back of my phone case. And in goes my phone. And I honestly love it. I think it looks super cool. It's different from like the one that I did a year ago. But yeah, this is another option that I wanted to share with you. So hopefully you like this too. If you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel for more stuff. Click on the notifications. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you later and take care. Bye guys.